Roger, thank you for agreeing to do this video interview with us. May we start off by asking, what have you been up to lately?
Well, for the past 10 years, in March and April, I do the same thing. I've been getting ready for the ISBI conference. And that always takes a lot of my time. We have the workshops we're certainly getting ready for. The Institute. The Institute this year was pretty exciting, actually. Although we had a smaller number, we had people from China there. We had people from Portugal, and we had people from Colombia. So I thought, from a small group, I thought it was great. Not only that, I worked with Mickey Lane on it, and we learned as much as the participants do in the course. So it was pretty exciting for us.
Excellent. Can you tell us about any publications, any articles or books that you've recently published and or are working on?
Well, thank you for asking. Yes. We just completed a book called Performance Architecture, the Art and Science of Improving Organizations. I was pleased to do that with two co-authors, Carol Haig and Lynn Carney. I worked with them for many, many years, and so we finally got everything down. I was really pleased also and honored to have Gary Rumler do the preface for me. So I think that was one of the last things he actually wrote before it was published. And so he also was gracious to open up his library for us. And that was fairly significant for the development of the book. And he's in the preface, he says, I've been asking Roger for 10 years to write this stuff down. So finally I did. And he got to see it. And Don Tosti actually wrote the afterword. So I've got two good people, forward and afterward, writing in there. And so I was really happy that I could do that. So, and then we continue with Carol Haig and I continue in Performance Express, doing the interviews with various people over, we've been doing this for maybe 5 or 6 years, on trend spotters. And what we've done now in the last couple of years have focused on tools and resources that people can use, and they're all online. And then I just talked to my friend Paul Harmon, who does a great newsletter on BPM, and we're going to start doing a quarterly report for his newsletter. So we're trying to tie the performance side into more of the systems thinking that he does. So those are the publications I've been up to lately.
Well, excellent. You've been a longtime member of the Society, and you are now a staff member, but I know that you were a volunteer many, many years here. Can you give us a little of your background, of your volunteerism for the Society, and what kinds of groups and task force and committees that you've been involved with?
Well, I have to go back and think about all those different committees and task force. I certainly started off at the chapter level, chapter president, although I attended ISBI a long time before that. Was interesting. I started when I was actually in high school attending. Well, maybe I'll get into that a little bit later. But at the chapter level, I think many people got started that way. So chapter president, then volunteering for different committees. I read a lot of proposals. And reading proposals is a good idea because you learn a lot what people are doing. So I encourage people to get on those committees. Certainly, one time we had chapter liaisons. I was one of those. I think that was, it's interesting thing, how things go around. I think they're going to maybe bring that back up again or some form of it. Then at the national level, I still kept involved with, volunteering for different committees and working with the conferences. I remember it was actually, we did it a little differently. We used to have people in charge of conferences. So you had a conference manager. Now, even though we have a conference manager now, when I was doing it, it's a little different. Because everything from, I know they hire audiovisual people now. I remember I went out to search for my audiovisual chairperson, and she went, and this was in San Francisco, she went to all corporations all over San Francisco bringing in, at that time all we had to have was overhead projectors. But projectors were, I think we had to have 150 projectors and flip charts, and